the king of Christmas fiction, is in studio with me. So I've got to ask, Mr. Richard Paul Evans, you are here. Before we get to Christmas, what is the one thing you don't want to see on your Thanksgiving plate?
I'm thinking that green bean casserole.
Yeah, I agree.
That's a little bit iffy.
Yep, I'm with you on that one. Well, we are so happy to have you in studio. Last time you and I were chatting on Zoom, so thanks for being here. How are you?
It's good to be back, and I'm sorry to see your arm.
Oh, it's just, yeah. you know, it's not a big deal. Let's talk about you, because you just wrote your 43rd book. How exciting is that?
Wow.
43. How do you come up with 43 storylines?
You know, I bleed every one of them, so it's always a gift.
I mean,
it's always a gift, so. But this, I remember when I first started, I saw, like, Mary Higgins Clark had, like, 60 novels. I thought, how is that possible? And I had two or three. And now it's like I look like one of those old guys.
Well, let's talk about The Christmas Promise. This is about two identical twins.
It is. It's the story of the prodigal son, but in this case, the prodigal daughter, told from the perspective of the older brother, so to speak.
Okay.
So Rochelle is talking about her twin sister, who they look completely alike, and they couldn't be more different. Her sister, she just sees her as wayward and a problem. And it's really about forgiveness and understanding and love. And it's you know, I think right now we need inspiring story, and so I'm glad this came out this year.
I think we all need a little hope. You know, after the last couple years, life has gotten everybody down, and it goes to show in the sales of your book, because sales are through the roof, right?
Yeah, actually, we're almost tripled the pre-orders. The sales are massive.
Wow.
It doesn't help that because of the supply chain, that when they sell out, it's like they can't get more in time for Christmas, so people are going kind of nuts buying it. It's like my first book, The Christmas Box, people got in fistfights over the last copy. So I'm telling my readers, like, you know, buy them early, if you wait till the week before Christmas, like I usually do, might not be there.
Yeah, well, you can have Christmas in July, right? If they don't get it in time, don't worry. Christmas is just going to keep on going. So for those, how about somebody that's never read your books? Why should they pick up a Richard Paul Evans book, and which one should they start with?
Well, they can start with this one. I just hope it's a fun read. That's what I don't write to be preach anything. I want someone to pick it up and not be able to put it down.
Okay.
And that's what the national reviewers have said about this. They read it in one gulp, and I just want it to be exciting.
Yeah, yeah, and give people hope this time of year, which it's been kind of a crazy couple years, hasn't it? And has it given you, I mean, you know, you're usually at home writing, but did COVID give you more time to write, or did it give you more story ideas?
Yeah, you know what's interesting is because I haven't gone on book tour, because I can't go on, you know, shake at 500 people's hands.
Right.
And so, like, I just went online, and I had 1,500 people come to one of my just spontaneous online. In fact, we had 50,000 on one.
Wow.
And it's just like, wow, maybe I should just stay home and do this in my basement.
It works. That's the silver lining, is that we've been able to do these virtual and online, you know, things that people might have not even been able to see you in person in the past if they lived far away or something. So it's great that you can communicate with your readers that way. So, Richard, how can we order the book so that we make sure we get it by Christmas?
You can get it anywhere. In fact, both Amazon and Walmart went 42% off, which is like unheard of. So it's almost half off. So it's a great time to stock up on Christmas presents.
Okay. Well, and are you ready for the holidays? Do you feel like it's always Christmas at your house, since you're always writing Christmas?
No.
You take a break?
No, my wife Carrie is a little bit OCD. Christmas makes her crazy. So we have this kind of conflict in a good way. I mean, I absolutely adore her. So it's kind of, you know, what works. But I mean, I would put a Christmas tree year round, and she has to limit it to a month. It's like past that, it will make her crazy. Yeah.
I like your wife. Tell Carrie,
like,
I'm totally with her on that. So, well, Richard, it's so fun having you in studio, and we look forward to your 44th book next year, right?
Thank you so much.
You write one a year?
Well, I'm doing the Michael Vay series is coming back, which people are excited about. So next year I'll have two books out.
Awesome. Can't wait. Well, Richard, thank you so much. Good to see you.
Thank you.